Also, the sun disappeared today. Lots of clouds in the air. Wonder if it's gonna rain. And what's going on today? I guess I read this at first, it made me wonder. There's actually like a reality show of sort when it comes to drones and stuff like that, specifically with LiDAR systems. Although I believe this is just made for the web. This one says, drone LiDAR documentary show makes some waves in the Louisiana marsh. Down to Earth, a surveying reality series journeys into the remote wilderness of the southern Louisiana wetlands to follow surveying and engineering firm Morris P. Hebert, Inc. as they use drone surveying equipment from micro drones to verify fill levels in a marsh restoration project. Now that name is confusing at first because it says equipment from micro drones. They don't mean an actual micro drone. That's the name of the company. Yeah, imagine like a micro drone with all these sophisticated LiDAR systems and all, huh? Down to Earth is a reality series that shows how real surveyors collect data and turn it into real deliverables despite challenging terrain, rough weather, and hidden dangers. For this project, we learned that coastal Louisiana faces some of the highest land loss rates in the world due to both natural and man-made factors. So that's basically what the show is by the looks of it. They go around, I guess, using the drone and collecting data out of it. Makes me wonder, is that really show-worthy overall? I guess it would be interesting from a tech point of view just to see how it works and all that, but I just wonder how interesting it would be for the average individual in terms of wilderness and stuff like that. I would imagine you'd much prefer to see things like getting crazy wildlife shots and all that. And I guess today there was a lot of, I guess, police announcements about gang members and stuff because there has been a lot of shooting and stuff around here. This one says Vancouver police warn public about six dangerous gangsters. And they show here the mugshots, I guess, of all six people. And it says Vancouver police today released the photos, names, and ages of six gangsters with links to Vancouver who pose a significant risk to safety of the public. Gang violence continues to be a prominent public safety issue in Metro Vancouver. There have been numerous reckless, brazen acts of violence that threatens the safety of innocent bystanders, says Chief Constable Adam Palmer. I want all Vancouver residents to know the faces of these individuals and to keep their distance from them. I thought we were all supposed to keep our distance anyways, although to my knowledge, the last shooting actually was pretty recent and it was at a restaurant. What would you say if you were a restaurant and you saw, I guess, one of these six people? Would you just turn them away after saying, oh, maximum occupancy, no more room outdoors? And the reason why they're releasing this too is because they say their police intelligence makes them believe that they are on the lookout from other gang members, so they're going to go after each other. It makes you wonder why they're so confident to do it right now. Is it just because, again, all these shutdowns and stuff like that, less people? Just to have the guts to do this again at places like the airport, that's kind of crazy.
Close.
You're used to me.
Oh, she's very trusting. Huh.
Right. See you guys later.